There are many critical things to consider before we can export as a DXF file for the laser cutter. For starters, you'll want to make sure your part is designed at a 1-to-1 scale based on your desired units of measure. Toggle open the document settings in the Fusion 360 browser and take note of the unit of measure. Make sure the unit of measurement, inches or millimeters, is what you intend to use when you upload your file for the laser. If not, you can simply select Change Active Units, select the correct unit of measure, and click OK. A quick way to check the size of your part is to simply select an edge of a 3D body. When selected, the length is displayed in the lower right corner. You can always alter the size if you're working with an imported model. If you have a native Fusion 360 file, you'll want to edit the sketches or features in your parametric timeline. If you're in direct modeling mode, meaning there is no parametric timeline, you can resort to the scale feature located in the Modify dropdown. With the scale feature, simply select the objects to scale, followed by the scale factor. This feature does not allow units of measure and may require some math to achieve a specific size. In some cases, reverse engineering imported parts may be necessary. Once your design is scaled for your needs, we'll want to project all of the edges into a single sketch. Doing so will allow you to quickly export the sketch as a DXF file, which we'll cover in the next lesson. I recommend starting with a new component, which will group the sketch as a unique part. This can be helpful if you need to copy, pattern, or insert the file into another design. Make sure the top level component is active before activating the new component feature. I'll simply name this Phone Stand Laser File, followed by the OK button. Because our new component is active, all of our parts will automatically have a lower opacity. This will also help us keep track of what's included in the active component. We now need to create a new sketch that will house each contour for the laser to cut. Simply select Create Sketch in the toolbar, followed by selecting the bottom origin plane. I recommend using the origin plane instead of the face of your parts. This will help you avoid potential errors if you alter any of the parts or place the component in another design file. Now that we're in an active sketch environment, we can utilize Fusion 360 sketch tools. In the Create dropdown, you will find a folder titled Project/Include. It's here that you'll find the Project command. Notice that it can also be activated with the keyboard shortcut letter P as in Papa. The Project command allows us to select bodies, edges, or sketch objects to automatically place or project into the active sketch plane. Before selecting any geometry, notice the selection filters in the Project dialog. By default, we can select any points, edges, or bodies. If we switch this to the Bodies option, we're only able to select three-dimensional bodies. Watch as I hover my mouse over one body. Notice the red outline that appears. This signifies the geometry that will be projected into our active sketch plane. Because we're using the body selector, the entire edge of the 3D body will be included. That's what we want, as we need the laser to follow the outer contour of the shape. If I switch to the Specified Entities option, you'll see that individual edges or points appear on hover. We could technically select all of the individual edges around the object to achieve the same result. However, doing so means we risk missing an entity. Any small segments missing from your contour will not be followed by the laser cutter. When possible, start with the body selector, which will help ensure you include the entire contour. Contrary, use the Specified Entities option if you need to project only specific edges or sections of your design. I'll select both 3D bodies. In this case, I also have some text in the design, so I'll need to select any additional islands or floating 3D bodies. In the Project dialog, Projection Link means this sketch will remain linked to the original source. That means our sketch will automatically update and adapt to any changes made to our 3D body. It's often best to leave this checked. However, uncheck this if you do not want the sketch to be driven by the original sketch or 3D body. Let's click OK and see what happens. I'll turn off the visibility of each component so we can take a closer look at the results. Notice projected geometry is represented by the pink or purple line color. This helps you understand what geometry has been projected and is still linked or driven from the original source. You will also notice that any closed profiles have a light blue background highlight. Any objects you would like completely cut out from the stock must include the blue background highlight. If no background highlight is present, there is likely a small gap between the sketch objects, which means the laser will not fully cut out the object. For example, I'll select one of the lower corners of the design, followed by the delete key. Notice how the blue background highlight disappears because of the gap in the contour. With that in mind, the background highlight is not sufficient when cutouts or small parts exist within an outer contour. It's also helpful to hover over each section that should be fully closed. If properly closed, you can select the profile by clicking in the middle of the shape. This is a great way to check cutouts and contours. Another thing to look out for is stray line segments or sketch entities that are floating in space. Any unwanted sketch objects can throw off the laser cutter. For starters, you can zoom out and click and drag over the entire canvas. Everything within the selection window will be highlighted. This is a quick way to catch any potential unwanted objects. Simply select unwanted objects and select the delete key on your keyboard. You can also select the zoom dropdown, followed by zoom to fit. This will fit the entire object or sketch within your screen. If your sketch appears to be further away or uncentered, then you likely have stray objects that need to be deleted. Once stray objects are removed, you'll want to double check the size of interior geometry. The size of any holes or interior geometry should be at least 50% of material thickness. This is because the laser pierces the material to begin cutting, which requires a certain diameter allowance for holes and internal shapes. Geometry smaller than 50% of the material thickness may result in inaccurate or substandard cuts. You can always utilize Fusion 360's measure tool or simply select geometry in your sketch to check the size. To summarize, you'll want to project each contour into a single Fusion 360 sketch. Make sure to remove any stray points or entities that may be floating in space, and double check that interior geometry is at least 50% of the material thickness. You may have noticed the text in this example phone stand. It's critical that all text is prepared for the laser cutter. In the next lesson, we'll discuss how to set up your text for successful laser cuts.